say I met him just once, but I can say that I was an ardent listener to his programs. I was listening to him even before he became the main presenter of that program. One thing that most people don't know, that I'm more political animal. I'm very much into what goes on in this world. And so I came here to do an interview, and I was stepping out, and I heard a voice call me, Bra. And I turned, and there was this gentleman who came and greeted me and said, Kaba. I said, wow. And after that, I went to Asempa a few times for interviews, and every time I was there, I told Kaba and Kojo Preko that the original Kojo is here, so today nobody uses Kojo. And it was something that we shared a lot over. You know, from his programs, the way he presented his programs, you could tell that he was a serious person, his research, and I mean, very particular about what he would do on the programs. I, at a certain time, used to host a similar program at a similar time at my station. So if I speak about his program, you should know that for me to start such a program on my station, it was because of what he was doing and how he was articulating his program. So I decided, okay, let me try and do something of that kind. But Kaba was on top. I mean, he had no match. We have lost a gem. We've lost a great presenter. Someone who was, I don't know whether there's a word called impartial, but he was impartial. I mean, when he was interviewed, I've heard a lot being said about him. I think we can learn from him, those who are planning to become radio presenters and all that, can learn from the way he took no sides. He was, if it's NDC, he knew what to ask. If it was MPP or CPP, and I think we need that when it comes to if you're a presenter. My main concern now is, after all these nice things, we've said all these nice things about him, what saddens me is the 7-month child that he left behind, and the wife, and the mother, and the parents, I mean, that's their only child. Everything about Kaba's death, the child, the marriage, and everything is, last year I heard that he was getting married, and everybody who came on his program was giving him, oh, Kaba, why are you? Say, why are you? Why are you fine? I kept hearing that. They say sometimes, I heard something saying that sometimes there are too many bad people in heaven. Sometimes God needs to plug some of the good ones amongst us to come and help you manage heaven. I pray that Kaba will be one of those people that God intentionally plugged for his kingdom. And we hope that we won't forget him, we won't forget what he's done for us, and we will not just have some symbolic thing somewhere, wrote the name after him, or a street or a lane or something named after him, so that at least someone may come one day to ask, okay, who is Kaba? Then we can at least give him that history for that legacy to live on.
Some have said that they should give him a state burial. Do you support that?
I am not. If they do, it's nice, but I think what happens after that is more important. The state burial will be just a one-day event, but like I said, if a street is named after him, that would be, I've seen the streets named Banana Street and Coconut Street somewhere in Accra. I think they can change that and use symbolic names among people who really left a mark like Kaba on one of them.
Okay. And you've listed a long list of things that he you fondly remember him for. Do you think there can be any Kaba who will find somebody like him again?
I think he left us something. He left, his footprints are all over the place. We're celebrating him now because out of the short life that he lived, he was able to leave something. The recordings that he did, the programs that he did, those that he met, he imparted there's some force that you cannot just meet him in. You know, I like I said, I met him on the day, and from that day onwards, I was already a fan of his program, but I became more like, I couldn't live without listening to the program in the afternoons. You know, and so I believe we have the footprints that we can slowly step into them. But then it gets to a point, this is where it comes up, some giants like him must be studied. I was here. My brother passed away in the UK, the BBC, what was his name?
Cobner
was here, saying those things. We should not let them just fade out. We are supposed to keep whatever they did alive, because the prints are there, the footprints are there. And if we want to study them, there are the records are there for us to learn from them.